So what I'm doing here is actually I'm choosing the exact lines that I want to adjust. Click on the transform tool, change the pivot, and adjust that section only. Yeah, so that actually seems more like my drawing. So I'm going to finalize the mount and go ahead and move it at this point. I mainly need to just reconnect the pieces. So we're pretty much done the head. As you can see, we could always save the final details such as the arrows towards the end, but now that we've got his head properly aligned, we could go ahead and finish up the rest of the body. So just make sure you're following these lines here while following the design flow from the reference. So we'll go and hide his hand part for now. Okay, so we won't need these blue lines, so let's go ahead and hide these as well. Hide the reference. Turn all these to black and see how it looks. So we could add the little touch-ups here, for instance, his belly button. So we could give definition to his muscles here. Yeah, so there you go, you pretty much have your whole character here ready. Alright, so now you're pretty much done. There's just one more thing. Character here seems to be a bit standing unnaturally. So just to give it more of an arc, I would suggest you do something like this. For instance, select the middle part of the character. And what we'll be doing is rotating this whole thing a bit behind. So once that's done, you can select the entire character and move this a little bit up. There you go, it's a bit more natural, so. And voila! we have an orthographic view of AANG from the front view and the side view. So thanks for tutorial the first part of this tutorial. Thanks for following the first part of this tutorial. I'll see you in the next one where we'll be coloring the rest of the character. I'll see you soon.